In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a light-up leaf, also known as a paper circuit leaf. Before we get started, you're going to need to gather a few supplies. You're going to need some tape, a pair of scissors, a coin cell battery, a circuit sticker LED, some conductive fabric tape, which may or may not be cut into strips for you, and some art supplies of your choice. I like colored pencils and Sharpie markers, but crayons, paint, and collage materials would also work well. Your teacher will be giving you a template that looks like one of these so that you can watch how I make a paper circuit leaf and follow along. Place your template on the table in front of you with a picture of the circuit positioned to your right. Use your fingernail to remove some of the protective backing off of the conductive fabric tape. You're going to be applying the sticky part to the template. We're going to start with the negative, the little minus sign. You're going to place that conductive tape over the gray mark on your template. And I'm using my thumb to kind of angle the tape in the direction that I want it to go. And when I get to the end, I'm going to use my scissors to cut off the extras so that I can use it later. Next, use your fingernail to remove the protective backing from a new piece of conductive fabric tape. This time, you're going to be placing the tape over the red line on your template, the one labeled as positive with a little plus sign. This line is a little bit trickier because there are more twists and turns that you have to make. If you turn your tape in the direction opposite of the direction that you want to go in, that's the best way to make those turns. When you get to the last turn, stop so that you can lay down the battery before you finish laying down your positive trace. Take a look at your battery. One side is bumpy, and the other side is smooth and has writing on it, and it also has a plus sign on it. The bumpy side is the negative. The negative side has to touch the negative piece of tape that you laid down. So with the bumpy side touching the negative lead, you're going to use your thumb to bring the positive lead, or the positive piece of conductive fabric tape, over the positive side of the battery. It's okay if the tape touches the edges of the battery. The edges of the battery are also positive. Press it down. You can keep the scrap for later. And then the next part is the fun part. The next part is you're going to lay down a circuit sticker LED and make sure that everything is working the way it should. Circuit sticker LEDs have a pointy side and a thicker, more flat side. We want to have the pointy side facing up. The pointy side is going to touch the negative side of the circuit, and the flat, big side is going to touch the positive side of the circuit. When you press the LED down, the light should turn on. I actually had to really push on my LED, and I also had to push on the battery to make sure that there was good physical and electrical contact. One thing that I like to do with my scraps is to take one little piece and put it on top of the negative pad, the little pointy part of the LED, and then cut a second little piece and put it over the positive pad of the LED. That just makes it stick a little bit better and often makes the light a little bit brighter. Once you've got your circuit working the way you want it, you can fold your template in half along the dotted lines. Sometimes I like to fold it before I lay the circuit down. It doesn't really matter what order you do it in. In this example, I folded it after I did my circuit. And I can see the lines through the paper, and I'm going to cut out my leaf shape. But I'm not going to cut the edge that's holding the two pieces of paper together. Okay, so now I have a leaf. Now I just want to tell you a couple of little tricks. So if I were to cut a small piece of paper, a little scrap piece of paper, and insert it in between the battery and the negative piece of conductive fabric tape, it interrupts the circuit and the light will turn off. If I pull it out, the light turns on again. Adding that piece of paper is like turning a light switch off. Sometimes I like to make a switch to turn my light off and then decorate my leaf. Your leaf does not have to look anything like mine. But this is one way that you could go about making a leaf. Just draw some lines with a marker. You could fill it in with colored pencils, you could use crayons, you could use paint. Your leaf doesn't have to be the actual colors of a leaf. Your leaf can be whatever you want it to be. I'm going to take my switch out, and then I'm going to tape it closed. Then I'm going to show you another little trick in just a minute. So sometimes I'll just take a little ball of tape to keep those two flaps together. Just stick it at the top. And then you can close the edges down. And it'll hold together. But sometimes you might notice that your LED is a little wonky or that it flickers a little bit. And if that bothers you, there is a way that you can fix it. So if your LED is flickering and you don't like it, gently remove the negative lead, flip your battery over, and you're going to be creating a small ball of tape using a scrap of conductive fabric tape. So I just created a little ball of conductive fabric tape. I'm going to place it on top of the negative piece of conductive fabric tape under the battery. I'm going to put the battery on top of that sticky tape ball, bring the positive lead over the battery and press it down really well. And now my circuit won't be quite as flickery. I can shake it and it won't flicker. And then I can tape it back together. Just keep in mind, if you add a tape ball, conductive fabric tape ball underneath, you won't be able to put a switch in there anymore. Now you know how to make your own paper circuit leaf. You can use the same skills that I taught you with any of the templates that you find here on this post. This one's a little trickier to cut, so maybe it won't be your first choice. Have fun making and decorating your own leaves.